Well, hello, hello, hello. Welcome to Tony's TapTV. This program is called Tap Internationals, and I produced it the first year of Tap City, the New York City Tap Festival. That was in 2001, and it was kind of the sleeper event. All international artists, and at the time, a lot of people just didn't know who these people were. And so they would be like, it was the sleeper event, definitely. Everybody was like, well, who are these people? And I'm like, well, you just wait and see. I had met a lot of these performers while I was traveling around the world as a tap dancer. And or they've been coming to New York, you know, to perform or study. So I pulled them into my first production of Tap Internationals. Now I've done several of them since. So I don't know. I just love this particular show. Enjoy it.
Hello. My name is Tony Waag, and I'm the producer of Tap City 2001, the New York City Tap Festival. Thank you for coming, and thank you for waiting. As you know, we're presenting tap classes all over Manhattan this week. We started on Saturday, actually. And now, here at the new, beautiful Duke on 42nd Street, we're presenting a whole week of tap performances that show the tremendous variety, scope, and internationality of tap dance as an art form. Last night we had tap kids. We had 67 yes. Tap kids performing here. And they were fantastic. Tonight we're presenting, and I have a list because I forget these countries, even though I've been to them. We're presenting outstanding dancers from Israel, Germany, Portugal, Japan, Switzerland, Brazil, France, Austria, and Estonia. So let's begin. And I, to guide you through this evening, it is my pleasure to introduce a very good friend of mine, my master, my mentor, my partner for 15 years. Forming the American Tap Dance Orchestra and operating Woodpecker's Tap Dance Center down in Soho for 6 years. She's a very good friend. She's my muse. She's my inspiration. She's everything to me. I don't think we would be here without Brenda Buffalino.
Quite a night. This is, both Tony and I got so emotional after the last show. Such an inspiration, the work that these dancers have done in the American art form, and how they've taken it, where they've developed it. It's just so exciting. And we're going to open tonight with Feraba. It's a traditional opening, really. An African drum and dance, how appropriate. And it's co-directed by Irene Colossius, Irina, you might know her better as, Irina, performing here with drummer Stefan Monson and dancer Chicago Iwahyo Puri. They're gonna give me a hard time in this. Arina is from Austria, and Chikako is from Japan. Stefan, however, is from the Bronx. Take it away. Let's welcome them.
Thank you.
wonderful group that will be performing for you is So De Zapato. And the director here is Claudio Figueira, and from Brazil. Yes, you know that. Name is Brazil by Shoes. That's what the name of this piece is. Claudio produces the biggest tap festival in South America. It's called TapIntern720. And I have had the privilege of working with him over there. And he also performs his Brazilian style solos internationally, all over the world. And tonight his vocalist will be Beatrice. Let's welcome So De Zapato. Brasil, pra mim, Brasil. Ever say that tap dance wasn't sexy? Take it back. Nice to see it move like that, isn't it?
Thrilling.
Hello. Well, we're going to have quite a change now. You're in for quite a dramatic treat. And this is a duet entitled Tapage, with Mari Fujibayashi from Japan and Olivia Rosencrantz from France. Now, they met in New York when they were dancing with the American Tap Dance Orchestra. And they have been doing a duet for quite a long time now. And this piece, which is called Chant for Killing a Snake, is an excerpt from a larger work performed with classical orchestra live with 65 musicians.
Thank you.
Tapage, Olivia Rosenkrantz, Mari Fukibayashi. Beautiful, beautiful. Bravo. Just breathe a minute. Really, it's so wonderful to see this form in depth, you know, where we can take it to, so many places. I mean, rhythm really, from the soul, the beginning of it all, really, even the end of it all. The next piece we're going to do is very wonderful. Companion piece to this last one. And this is a rhythm, Kanoko and Say. And they're working with a shamisen instrument, an ancient instrument brought to Japan from China 500 years ago. And I think we will really enjoy this.
Thank you.
Rhythm says that's her favorite instrument to work with now. A smoking shamisen. That was really swinging there for a while, wasn't it? Amazing. Well, we're going to see a bit of, we just spoke a little bit of the soul of the rhythm. We're going to see a bit of the soul of Brazil in this next artist. I saw her perform in Brazil a few years ago when I had the opportunity to go. And I just love the spirit that emanates from her wonderful moves and her joyous love of tap dance. If we have helped to spread anything in America, by sending tap dance out, we've helped to spread joy. And here is where it lives, in Cynthia Martin.
Thank you.
does travel well. And many places that it travels by. Come on, sweetheart. Yes, don't trip now. Walk carefully. Bye-bye. Many of the places it travels back to us, as you know. You know, I mean, we have been very influenced by Brazilian music. As well as sending our taps there, we love to dance to Brazilian music and the rhythms. And two gentlemen that are coming up now, also from Brazil, actually have traveled all over the world and probably started out as Americans a long, long time ago, and are now in Brazil together. And it's Stephen Harper and Bruce Henry. Bruce Henry on the bass, Stephen Harper on taps. And they're doing a piece called Jungle Taps. And it shows yet another dimension even of Brazil. Thank you.
original piece called Tip Tap Toe. And the next number is a choro, a Brazilian song form, typically from Rio de Janeiro, that was developed in the late 19th century. It's from our show Jungle Tap, and this one's called Odeon.
Introduce now our band members. This wonderful band, all the members have worked with tap dancers for many years. Frank Kimbrough, our piano player, worked with the ATDO for so many years and was such a great support. We love them, they love us, that's what we need. Frank Kimbrough on piano. Ben Allison on bass. Eddie Ornofsky on drums. Welcome. I'm glad to have some company here. I'm just going to stand up and sit down a minute. There, that was good. Thank you, Eddie. Well, now we're going to move to Israel. And I'm going to make a little announcement because the two gentlemen who spearhead this company, Tap Tel Aviv, are Ofra Ben and Avi Miller, who have had so much wonderful work in our festival. They deserve a great deal of thanks and applause for their great work. Now, the dances they're doing with their dancers from Israel, they're going to perform to Caravan. Now, I'm not sure this is what Duke Ellington had in mind for this piece. But, you know, he did some very oriental, interesting things, so he might really have gotten some ideas from it. Avi says, Avi told me that he got some ideas from me from when I was over there teaching with him for many, many years. So I'm watching every step to see what he lifted. I would like to present to you TapTV.
Thank you.
have our own little world here. And you stay here long enough, you have two shows, you start having lunch. Well, so now I think maybe I could tell you a little bit of a story of when the some members of the ATDO went to Eastern Europe. We were sent by the United States Information Service on a kind of ambassadorial tour. That was when they were sending artists instead of computer salesmen. They stopped doing that, I think, after us. I didn't mean that the way it sounded. But anyway, we went right after the communists had left, when these countries were becoming free. And one of our first stops was Łódź, Poland. And it was really shocking to us how very, very poor it was, and how depressed the people were, how sad. And you know, I had always wondered about being a tap dancer. Is this the right thing to be doing with a life? Shouldn't I be doing something more serious? Especially as I'm a grandmother. And so we were doing the music of Hoagy Carmichael and a piece called The American Landscape. And as people came into the theater, it was a beautiful theater. The city was decimated, but the theater was beautiful. And the people came in and it was so quiet. And as we danced, you could feel the spirits of the audience lift with our music and dancing. And I don't think I ever felt so proud to be a tap dancer, to see how rhythm and tap and our beautiful music actually can change and elevate the spirit. What a wonderful thing to do with a life. I never asked that question again, whether it was a worthy profession or not. And then we went on to Estonia. And we found dances everywhere we went, even in Estonia. And there we met the next act I'm going to introduce, Alexander Ivaskevich. And he was there with his tapshoes. Now Barbara Duffy said, Alexander, come to America, come to Woodpeckers. Sure enough, there he was, not long, very industrious, these Estonian people. Anyway, Alexander is really a professional actor, and he is with the Russian Drama Theater and was awarded the title of Best Actor in Estonia in the year 2000. Yes. And he told me he considers the ATDO his parents in TAP and named his studio in Estonia after Barbara Duffy, his main teacher. I would like to introduce you to Alexander Ivaskevich, singing and dancing to a Russian song and dance called The Small Cinema. Alexander.
Поцелуй. Майка в моем кино.
It's a great privilege for me to introduce this next young lady who's really been a part of the Tap family for such a long time, since she was a little girl, traveling with us in a lot of the festivals with her mom. So I had I hadn't seen her for quite a few years, because she's been living in France all this time and considers herself a Parisian. But I saw her, I worked with her last year in an Atlanta festival. And I just was, wow, what happened to Lila Petronio? Well, I'm so happy to introduce you to her. Take the stage, Lila. Thank you. now we're going to move. Right now, we're going to go to Germany. And I have spent a great deal of my time performing in Germany. And so appreciate the way we are appreciated there, our art form. And when the first time I performed there, someone came up out of the audience and said, "Wow, you dance just like Lenny Tristano." I was amazed that anybody knew who Lenny Tristano was, not only that I danced like him. I was very impressed. They really have a great love for our form and probably know a lot more about it than we do. The next group that's going to be out is a duet, Tap a Toe, Christina Delius and Anina Kruger. Also have a very original take and have an extra flavor because Christina is from Portugal, Anina is from Germany, and they've been collaborating on pieces since 1995 and are the founders of Tap a Toe Studio in Brazil, and they teach only tap dance, no aerobics, no modern, no jazz, only tap dance. And you really feel this wonderful collaboration of countries and influences from their beautiful work, beautiful girls. Please welcome Tap a Toe.
Thank you.
heard tonight. Wow, people have great, wonderful ideas. So interesting and exciting. Well, we're at our last number now. This has been quite a night for me. These people have touched me very deeply over the years as I've traveled and watched them. And tonight, it's just so wonderful to have them here. And now for our final act, two gentlemen who really bring tap dance back home to America, bring the style right from their hearts. This is not something they said, oh, that's a good idea. This is something they do from their hearts. They bring the early style right back to us. And they would like to dedicate this tonight to their friend, Fay Ray, and to their mentor, Carnell Lyons, who was with the Businessmen of Rhythm, and Jesse James and Carnell. I'd like to present to you Kurt Albers and Klaus Blythe.
Thank you.
Well, we're going to close with that traditional shim sham. That is the dance, as Honey Cole said. All over the world, people know this dance. And here we are today to prove it. Tony, come on down and join us. Tony Waag, join us in the shim sham. One, two, one, two, three.